Robbie Weeds here. Wanted to talk to you a little bit about tying down machines. This is a machine that weighs about 3,000 pounds. I have it tied down at three points, two in the front, one in the back, depending on the weight and what type of strapping mechanism, whether it's chains or straps. Some states require four tie down points. Right now I have three. It's all about redundancy. That is that they want at least one or maybe even two straps can fail and the actual machinery isn't going anywhere. So that's why they want like more than two tie down points, so that one or two can fail and nothing happens. Another principle that you're going by is you want to make sure you're pulling the machine in opposite directions. That keeps it in one spot. So sometimes, you know, I see people pulling forward, or the only time you can pull both forward is if you're pulling into the front, you have something stable or rock solid to pull into. Say if the suspension or something, some part of the frame could be supported by the front of the trailer, or if there's some really sturdy point where the can handle the tension and the weight of the machine, and you could pull the entire machine into that and you could have all the straps pulling to that point. But other than that, you want to have you know, the machine being pulled in opposite directions. You do want to compress the suspension somewhat. I do read that compressing the suspension too much can damage the suspension, but I would rather fix springs and dampeners than have my machine fly off. So that's how I feel about it. You know, springs and dampeners go bad anyway, and you know, just having that go wear out a little quicker and knowing that my machine doesn't bounce around on the trailer or scare people makes me feel a little better. So that's how I strap down my tractor, my Z-Spray, a little lighter. As you can see, it's tied down being pulled in two different directions. At points where on this there's no suspension, but it's being pulled in two directions. At points where it's very sturdy on the machine, it's pulling the whole mass of the machine. It's not on points where it's top heavy. The whole machine is being pulled down and in different directions, so that's how to keep it very sturdy. These straps aren't in great condition. You know, you do want to make sure your straps are good. The twist in them isn't great. That's probably a citation right there. So before I get out of here, I'll change that around. But yeah, that's how I strap down my machines. It's how I've been doing it for a decade. I'm sure it could be done a little better, but I've been stopped at plenty of Department of Transportation stops, and they've been okay with this. So, and I obviously need some new straps, but yeah, this is how I do it. Robbie Weeds out.